गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द टोटल प्रोडक्ट. सो टुडे व्हाट इज टोटल प्रोडक्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट. सो लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट द शॉर्ट टर्म एंड लॉन्ग रन. सो आई होप यू आर क्लियर विद द शॉर्ट रन एंड लॉन्ग रन. इन शॉर्ट रन देर आर टू एलिमेंट्स कम्स, दैट इज फिक्स्ड फैक्टर्स एंड वेरिएबल फैक्टर. Whereas in long run, all the factors are variable factor. There is no fixed factors are there in the long run. So today we are going ahead with the topic total product. Suppose we vary a single input and keep all other input constant. Here they are telling that we are going to keep one element as a constant and another element as a vary. That means that is goes on changing. We vary a single input. One single input is going on changing and keep all other inputs are constant. So you can ask a doubt, how can be same time one variable can be constant and one variable can be vary. So here we can take an example of labor and capital. So if we are taking a example of labor and capital, suppose vary a single input. A single input in the sense we can vary the labors, the number of labors we can change, and keep all other input constant. That means we are going to keep constant as a capital. So that time what happens, that we are going to study. One single is varying and another all other inputs are going to be constant. That means here the labor is changing and capital is going to be constant one. There is no changes in the capital. Then for different levels of input we get different level of output. That and what happens for the same combination, when it changes, when we are changing the amount of labor by keeping constant in the capital, the output what we are getting, as the level increases, the output also goes on changing. This relationship between the variable input and output, keeping all other input constant, is often referred as total product of the variable input. Total product of the variable input. So total product of the variable input means we are varying one single input and keeping all other inputs as a constant. When that happens, what we are going to produce? By keeping the constant, what we are going to produce, that we will call it as a total product. So total product, we will write it as a TP. So you have to keep it in mind, what is TP? So in exam, they will ask, explain TP. They may not ask what is total product. They can ask you directly what is TP. That time you should know TP means total product. Total product of the variable input. How we got total product of the variable input? By keeping one single input as vary and keeping all other input as a constant. Here we are talking about the input. So the relationship between this variable, we will call it as a total product. In next para, they have given the example of table 3.1. Table 3.1 is a table which we studied in our last class. So if you remember, in last class we studied about one table where it shows the different combination of capital and labor. They are talking about that example. So let me go through that. So here they are keeping one variable as a varying one. That means one variable goes on changing and another variable, another input is going to be constant one. So let us take that they are going to keep fixed as a capital, that is 4 unit. So what happens? Okay, so this is the chart which we are using. So in that they are going to keep constant as a fourth one, that is they are going to keep constant as a capital, that is fourth one. And here you can see the labor, the amount of labor is goes on changing. When you are using zero amount of capital and when you are taking 4 unit of capital, what happens here again? Zero, because we are using zero labors. Now your capital is constant, that is 4 only, but your labor, what you are using, it is one labor. You are using here 4 is the capital, you are using one labor, and capital is constant only. So what it will be your production? Your production will be 10. Now you are taking 2 labors, but capital is again constant, it is 4 only. What will be your production? It will be 24. Second, you are taking 3 labors, but your capital is constant, 4. What will be your output? It will be 40. So it will goes on changing. When you vary a single input, here you are varying only a single input, that is number of labor, and keep all other input constant. Which one you are keeping as a constant? Capital. Here throughout this concept it will goes on remain constant. So what happens? The output which you are getting with the constant capital will varies, it will goes on changing, that they have mentioned here. So we get the output value of the different value of labors. When the labors amount varies, the output also varies. This is the total product of the labor schedule with K2 is equal to 4. K2 is nothing but capital is equal to 4. Why capital is equal to 4? Because we are using here one constant number, that is capital is equal to 4. Okay, K2 is equal to 4, that means K2 is equal to 4, they mentioned here, that is nothing but capital 4. So this is also sometimes called total return, or total return to, or total physical product of the variable input. So there are another two names which we will call it as a total return or total physical product. This is shown again in the second column of the table 3.2. So in 3.2, that will come after studying total product, average product, marginal product, you have to calculate. That time that schedule will come. Once we have defined the total product, it will be useful to define the concept of average product and marginal product. Once we are able to find out what is total product, next two elements to find out another two elements, it will going to be very easy, because everything is related to total product. If we find out the total product, next we easily we can find it out average product and marginal product. They are useful in order to describe the contribution of the variable input in the production process. So what is the variable input input contribution that we can define? So regarding this concept, no need of writing notes. So it will come for only for 2 marks, and you have to know this concept to do the calculation. Further calculation is there, so that time you should know the meaning of total product. So that's why this question will come for 2 marks. So when I will finish with the 3 concepts, I will give you the notes. And previous class, which and all the concept I have done in 3rd chapter, that is production function, introduction, for the those concept no need of notes, just for understanding. Only notes is required for isoquant. So that I will send you today. I will send you one screenshot. So you will goes on writing that. Remaining other concept, no need of writing any notes. Only for isoquant, notes is required. So other things like short run, long run, total product, you should know the meaning. If you know the meaning, it is enough. Nothing more is required. You have to know the meaning and it will come for 2 marks. So when by the end of the concept, I will write it 2 marks question and answer and I will send it to you. So by that time, don't worry about the notes. Just try to understand the concept. Today I will send you the one picture of isocont that you write. Okay. Thank you, students.